Finding the kernel range of a transformation is often difficult or even impossible. But if we have a matrix transformation, then we can find them explicitly and easily. In fact, they turn out to be some very well-known subspaces. Let us see in this video what they are. So, suppose we have a linear transformation T from V to W. Now T linear and V and W are both vector spaces. So what are the kernel and the range? We know the definition. The kernel of T is a set of all vectors in the domain, so also a set of all vectors V in V, such that the image T of V equals the zero vector, which is some subset of the domain V. And the range of T is a subset of the codomain W, is the set of all vectors small w in the vector space W, such that you can reach it, such that there is some V in the domain, such that T of V equals W. What about a matrix transformation? What if you have a transformation from R3 to R2, and if T is given by some matrix A, so T of X equals A times X. So let's do an easy example. A is the matrix 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. And now we want to determine the kernel of T and the range of T. Well, you know straight away the domain and the codomain. Of course, you can read them off. The domain is R3, codomain is R2. So you know that the kernel will be some subset of R2, and you know that the range will be some subset of R2. Now, let's determine the kernel first. Well, the kernel is the set of all vectors x, such that T of x equals A times x equals 0. So you have to find the vectors x such that A times x equals 0. Well, you know how to do that. It's just solving it in your system. So you form the augmented matrix. Row reduction step over here. Now you have the row reduced echelon form, and you can write down the general solution. X, you have two free variables, x2 and x3, and there we are. So you see that x is in the kernel of the transformation T. If x is a linear combination of minus 1, 1, 0 and minus 1, 0, 1. So the kernel of T is the set of all linear combinations of minus 1, 0 and minus 1, 0, 1. And that's in fact the same as the null space of the matrix A. And it always holds, of course, because the null space of the matrix A is exactly the set of vectors, such as A times X equals 0. And it's the same as the kernel. So if you have a matrix transformation, then you can easily determine the kernel of the transformation T, because it's the null space of the standard matrix. Well, I think you can now already guess what the column space will, what the range will be, the column space, but let's check. The range of T, how can we find this? You take some general vector X consisting of C1, C2, and C3, and we wonder where we get. So we take an arbitrary vector in the domain. Then T of X equals A times X equals A times this arbitrary vector, and in this case that will be C1 plus C2 plus C3, so times 1, 2. So if you take an arbitrary vector in the domain, you always end up with some multiple of 1, 2. So the range of T, the vectors you can reach, are all linear combination of 1, 2 in this case, or the span of 1, 2, and it's exactly the same as the column space of A, and holds in general, of course. So if you have a linear transformation given by some matrix A, you can also easily determine the range of the transformation. That's the same as the column space. So actually determining kernel and range for a matrix transformation is easy, because we encounter some old, well-known subspaces, the null space of A for the kernel and the column space of A for the range of the transformation.